In part one of our lesson on powers and roots of complex numbers, you will learn how to derive and use DeMoivre's theorem. We'll start off by letting z be the complex number r cis theta, which we know in expanded form is r times the quantity cosine theta plus I sine theta. And recall that the product rule is Z1 times Z2 is equal to R1 times R2 cis theta 1 plus theta 2. We're going to use the product rule to help us get a rule about taking powers of complex numbers. So let's look at z squared. We know that means it would be z times z. So that is r cis theta times r cis theta. Now the product rule says that you take the two radii and multiply them together. So we'll take r times r, and that's going to be r squared. Then the product rule says we'll take cis of the sum of the two angles. So we have theta plus theta, which would be 2 theta. Now we're going to use that result to help us find z to the third. We can think of z to the third as z squared times z, so that would be r squared cis 2 theta times r cis theta, and we will once again apply the product rule. So we know we have to multiply the two radii, so we're multiplying r squared times r, which would give us r cubed, cis the sum of the two angles. So we're adding 2 theta plus theta, which would be 3 theta. We could do the same thing now. Z to the fourth, we can write as z to the third times z. So we have r cubed cis 3 theta times r cis theta. The product rule says to multiply the radii, so we have r cubed times r is r to the fourth cis the sum of the two angles. We have 3 theta plus theta is 4 theta. So now let's notice something. Z squared became r squared cis 2 theta. Z to the third became r to the third cis 3 theta. Z to the fourth became r to the fourth cis 4 theta. So now we are going to extrapolate and say then that z to the n is going to be r to the n cis n theta. And this is DeMoivre's theorem. So now we have a really simple way to take powers of complex numbers. So let's try an example and see how that's going to work. In this example, we have to evaluate the quantity 1 plus I to the fifth power using DeMoivre's theorem. We are told to use radian angles in your trig form, then put your final answer into rectangular form. Now, remember, if we look at DeMoivre's theorem, we need for our complex number to be in trig form. So the first step is going to be to draw a picture and put Z into trig form. We have Z is equal to 1 plus I. This is the complex number that we will take to the fifth power later using DeMoivre's theorem. So let's make a diagram of Z. We know the real part is 1, and the imaginary part is also 1. There's Z. We can find R and theta using our definitions. We know that R, of course, is the square root of x squared plus y squared. So that's going to be the square root of 1 squared plus 1 squared, which is radical 2. We also know that tangent of theta has to be y over x, which is equal to 1 divided by 1, which is 1. From our special angle chart, we know that theta is going to be pi over 4. So putting Z into trig form, we get that Z is equal to radical 2 cis pi over 4. Now that we have Z in trig form, we will use DeMoivre's theorem. Which we know says z to the n is equal to r to the n cis n theta. Remember, in this problem, we were being asked to evaluate 1 plus I to the fifth. So we are taking z to the fifth power. So we will be doing r to the fifth cis 5 theta, and we have z in trig form here, so we know that our value for r is radical 2, and our value for theta is equal to pi over 4. So we get radical 2 to the fifth power cis 5 times pi over 4, now radical 2 to the fifth, remember every two radical 2s becomes a 2, so we have radical 2 times radical 2 times radical 2 times radical 2 times radical 2, so every pair turns into a 2, and then we have a radical 2 left over. So this is going to be 4 radical 2. So we have 4 radical 2 cis 5 pi over 4. Now this would be the trig form of the answer. And we were instructed to put our final answer into rectangular form. So that means we have to expand out the trig form. So this will be 4 radical 2 times the quantity cosine of 5 pi over 4 plus I times the sine of 5 pi over 4, which equals 4 radical 2 times the quantity five pi over four lives here in quadrant three. We know that our reference angle is going to be pi over four. Looking at our special angle chart, we see in the pi over four column that cosine is radical 2/2, and we know in quadrant three cosine is negative, so we get negative radical 2/2 plus I times the sine of 5 pi over 4. We go to the pi over 4 column into the sine row. The value is radical 2/2, and in quadrant 3, sine is negative. So we get negative radical 2/2. Next, we have to distribute the 4 radical 2 to each of these terms. When we multiply here, we're going to get a radical 2 times a radical 2, which we know is 2, and then that will cancel with this 2 in the denominator. So 4 radical 2 times negative radical 2/2 is just going to become negative 4. Then we have 4 radical 2, once again, times negative radical 2/2, so we know that that's going to become minus 4i, and this is our rectangular form.